Carte Noir, it's back. I'm so glad. The confusing thing that happened to Carte Noir was Mondelez Craft sold off the coffees division. So Carte Noir was sold to two separate companies. The retail part of it, of ready-made instant coffee, was sold off to Jacob de Wijkbertz, who renamed it Lo. And the coffee shops and beans and pods, you know, and them things that you put into the Nespresso, that sort of stuff, and Tassimo, that was sold off to Lavazza. And what happened was Carte Noir disappeared from the supermarkets, leaving us with Lo, which it really felt like Jacob de Wijkbertz just got their usual coffee and put it in the same jar that looked like this. This is actually a really old jar of Carte Noir, which I've had for quite a long time now. I'm still working my way through this. I've still got three jars of this left. But anyway, proper Carte Noir's back! And they've gone really mad on the QUs, you know, because obviously it's more French now. And it's like classy. And, or is it Italian? It'd be Italian. But anyway, it's delicat and aromatique. So lots of QUs. Le plus belle connaisseur de noir. That's not the English side. Where's the English side? Oh, underneath. It says, at Carte Noir, our master roasters craft our blends with passion and expertise to release the finest aromas in each of our coffees. The passion for excellence and the meticulous blending of the best beans reveal the finest aromas. Rediscover the unique pleasure of Carte Noir in instant coffee. Finally, I hope that this is going to pick up from the atrocity that was Le. I don't like Le at all. I think Le was very Le quality. Anyway, let's get some meat! If anyone's watching my series, Will It Or Cook? This is the separate machine. This is the one. As you can see, it's still soup stained. I'm so glad. I'm going to stick my nose right in this. I love sticking my nose in a brand new jar of coffee. Oh, look at that. I like it when it's always got a gold seal on it as well. It's much nicer. Stick my nose in there. You see, that just smells better. It smells better. So I'm going to put in. There we go. I'm going to put that on there. Stir. It's a big mug, by the way, that's why it's only half full. I can actually put two loads in there, but I do love this machine, but I like my coffee a bit cooler. I like to drink a cup of coffee when I'm thirsty. I don't want to sit and look at it for half an hour. And here's a big shock horror for you. Look, I'm using blue top milk. Blue. There we go. Good of milk in there. Do love a good bit of cow squeeze. There we go, give it a stir again. And I know this is probably gonna like shock a lot of people, but a few candorels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we are. And okay, it's a few. And one. Give it a mixy. Isn't it funny how you mix anything thicker than to your coffee? Yeah. You stir a cup of tea or coffee, but you mix anything else. Weird, isn't it? So after a few years of no more Carte Noir, is this going to reinvoke my love of the brand and coffee, of course, of Carte Noir? Yes. It went on the wrong hole. Yes, I am glad it is back. This is lovely. I know a lot of people don't like instant coffee, but as instant coffee goes, I love my Carte Noir and I'm glad it's back. Oh yeah, lovely. Anyway, thanks for watching. It's Grass. See you when I see you. Bye. It's really, really good. Try Carte Noir today. Oh, if you can't get out today, go tomorrow.